Hello, children. Welcome back. How are you feeling today? I hope you are feeling great because it is a wonderful day to make your English even better and to learn a lot of interesting things around us. My name is Chulpan Kalandarova and I'm your English teacher. Children, look at these pictures and think, what word can be used to describe all of them? That's traditions. Look at the people in the pictures. Who do you think they are to each other? Yes, they're family. So today we will talk about family traditions. But before, we will learn what tradition itself is. Tradition is a culture, beliefs, customs, and history of groups that pass down from parents and grandparents to children over many years with symbolic meaning. Usually, traditions include things such as rituals, beliefs, customs, stories, songs, food, and gatherings that we follow. Let's talk about different traditions around the world that connect families and relatives. Do you know any Kyrgyz traditions? Great! Have you heard of the tradition that is called Tushokesu? Tushokesu is a Kyrgyz tradition which is held when the child is 1 year old and he just begins to walk. Wishing him a bright future, his parents cut a sheep devoted to him and organize a big toy. They invite relatives and neighbors. And after the guests had had a meal and given blessings for the child, his parents invite the guests to the race competition for children. They tie up the child's leg with a black and white striped wool cord. The children race from a certain distance. And the first and second winners have right to cut the cord and walk with the child, taking him by his arms. The first winner is usually given an expensive present and a knife with which he has cut the cord. The other participants are also given various toys and sweets. There are also a lot of other interesting traditions, for example, Chuseok. It is one of the biggest and most important holidays in Korea. Chuseok was traditionally a time in which families gathered together to give thanks to their ancestors for a plentiful harvest, which is similar to the Thanksgiving Day in the USA. Koreans celebrate Chuseok by making special foods, particularly a certain kind of rice cake called Singapun. On the eve of Chuseok, family members gather to make Singapun together, illustrating the importance of family in Korean society. In the contemporary South Korea, people travel from large cities to their hometowns to pay respect to the spirits of their ancestors. Until these days, holiday has been a time where families get together to enjoy each other's company. There are also some smaller, more private traditions between parents and their children, like shared everyday rituals or during holidays. They are called family traditions. Family traditions tell a story about who you are and what's important to your family. Now, my dear students, we will listen to a poll. He will introduce his family to you and tell about his family traditions. Listen carefully and try to memorize the information, because after listening to Paul, you will do the quick test. Hi, welcome to my home. My name is Paul. I'm 12 years old and this is my beautiful family. There are 6 people in my family: my mom, my dad, my 2 sisters, my younger brother and me. This is my sister Olivia, who is 10. She's in the 4th grade. She loves reading. Her favorite subject is English. This is my younger brother, Oliver, who is 7. He is in the 1st grade. He loves playing games with his spinning top. He never seems to have enough. This is my younger sister, Lucy, who has just turned 4. She is in the kindergarten and loves playing her dolls. We get along very well and love each other very much. But, well, sometimes we have our fights and arguments too. We usually make up soon afterwards. My mom is a nurse and she works in a hospital. She is so kind and compassionate and she always takes good care of the sick people. When she gets home, she always helps us with our homework. My mom is an excellent cook and she loves to bake delicious cakes. My dad is a photographer. He travels pretty often with his job to make great pictures in different places. When he returns home from his travel, he tries to spend as much time as possible with us and we have a lot of fun together. On weekends, we sometimes go on bike rides together. You learned about Paul and his family. Now I will ask you questions and you try to answer them. The first question, how many people are in Paul's family? That's right, there are 6 people in his family. How old are his sisters and brothers? Good job, they are 10, 7 and 4 years old. What does his mother do? Yes, she's a nurse. What does his father do? Good job, he's a photographer. How do they spend time together? They have a lot of fun and sometimes go on bike rides together. Children, what adverbs of frequency do you remember from the last lesson? Great. So let's anyway revise the topic by listening to a song.
How often do you brush your teeth?
How often do you?
Always, always. Always brush my teeth. How often do you? How often do you use chopsticks?
How often do you?
Usually, I usually use chopsticks. How often do you take out the trash?
How often do you?
Often, I often take out the trash. How often do you? How often do you do the laundry?
How often do you?
Sometimes do the laundry. How often do you? How often do you make cookies?
How often do you?
Rarely, I rarely make cookies. How often do you drive a car?
How often do you?
Never, I never drive a car.
Today is a special day because we will do the project that is called My Family Traditions. For a project, you should get an album paper, pen, colored pens, and watercolors. After getting the items, divide your paper into 6 sections, as in the example. In the first section, you should answer to the following questions and write them down on your paper. First question, how many people are in your family? Then what are their names? How old are they? And what are their hobbies? For example, you can write like this. I have a small family. There are 4 people including me. Their names are Timur, Asil, and Arsen. They are 45, 40, and 7 years old. Their hobbies are reading, cooking, I'm playing football. Start writing your answers to the given question now. Remember, you should write down your answers in the first section. The second question is, what do people in your family always do? For example, you can say, we always have dinner at 7 o'clock. Write down 3 or 4 sentences about what people in your family always do. Don't forget, you should write your answers in the second section. The question number 3 is, what do people in your family often do? Answer to the question as in the example. We often cook plov. Write your answer in the third section. What do people in your family sometimes do? Look at the given example and start writing your answer now. Good job, guys! Keep writing! 2 more sections and we are done. Question number 5. What do people in your family hardly ever do? You can write your answer like in the example. We hardly ever go abroad. Write 3 or 4 sentences. What do your family almost never do or hardly ever do? And the last question is, what do people in your family never do? For example, you can write, we never drink cold tea. Write 3 or 4 sentences about what people in your family never do. Children, we are almost done. Don't give up, because after finishing the task, we will have a rest and sing a song. And we have finished. You can draw some pictures on your poster to make it more beautiful. So, let's have a look what I've got so far. This is my family traditions poster. And now, show me yours. Wow, it's great! I like it! You did a great job today, and I'm very proud of you. And now you deserve to have a rest and listen to a song. Have fun!
Hello kids, I'm Jack. Let's listen to I Love You, You Love Me, We Are a Happy Family.
Every day is special when you spend it with people you love.
I love you, you love me, we are one big family. With a hug and a kiss and an I love you, won't you say you love me too?
Raining or sunny, no matter what happens, you all are very special to me.
I love you, you love me, we're best friends like friends should be. With a big bear hug and a kiss from me to you, won't you say you love me too? And then I love you, won't you say you love me too?
Let's do the quick test and revise topics we have passed. Here, you can see the question with two options. Choose the one which you think is correct. Let's get started. Question number one, do we use present simple when we are talking about action that is happening right now? The correct answer is no, we don't. The second question, do we add S ending to the verb with subjects he, she, it? Yes, we do, or no, we don't. It's yes, we do. The next question, which is a signal word for simple present, often or now? Well done, it's often. Which auxiliary verb is used to make a question with I, you, we, they? Do or does? Perfect, it's do. Do we use signal words such as always, usually, after the main verb in the present simple? Yes, we do, or no, we don't. Right answer is no, we don't. Because as we learned earlier, signal words or adverbs of frequency come before the main verbs. Which short answer is correct? Does she do the housework? Yes, she does. Or yes, she do. Perfect. It's yes, she does. Do we add S ending to the verb in the question starting with does? Yes, we do. Or no, we don't. That's right. Yes, we do. The next question. Do we add S ending to the verb in the question starting with does? Yes, we do. Or no, we don't. That's right. No, we don't. Do we use present simple if the action is repeated every day? Yes, we do. Or no, we don't. The correct answer is yes, we do. Do we add ed ending to the verb in the present simple? Yes, we do. Or no, we don't. Great job. No, we don't. What ending do we use with the main verb watch? S or ES? Perfect. ES. Unfortunately, it is the end of our lesson. You studied hard and learned a lot, and I hope you enjoyed it. So I wish you to have a wonderful holidays. And remember, it's great to have your family around you. So try to spend more time with your family and don't forget to hug and say that you love them. I'm your English teacher, Chulpon Kalandarva. See you next time. Bye-bye.